Namaste. This is Matrishva from Matrishva as clinical and wildlife photographer. In this video, we will learn how to make background of an image appear black using the concept known as dynamic range. The effect you will learn looks like this. So let us first understand what is this dynamic range. It is the difference between the lightest and the darkest area or the tone in an image. Each camera has its own dynamic range. That means the capacity to record the whitest and the darkest area varies from camera to camera. Generally, the dynamic range of a camera ranges from plus to minus 5 stops, and that is the maximum a camera can see. However, a human eye can see more than what a camera's dynamic range can capture. So let us simplify it further with the help of this example. Here I have 20 shades from black to white, and say for instance each shade represents one stop. So if I expose for the stop number 20 or the tone number 20, then camera will see up to shade number or tone number 11. Any shade falling between 1 to 10 will be captured as totally black. Similarly, say for example, if I expose for this tone number 5, then it will record the details in tone number 1, tone number 10. All tones beyond that will be recorded as blown out whites. So I think you got the idea. And we use this phenomenon to our advantage when photographing a subject with great contrast. When I expose the highlights by taking a meter reading from the bright area, camera will do so at the expense of underexposing the shadow areas to the point that its detail is not retrievable in most of the cases. Contrary to it, if I expose for the shadow areas, it will overexpose the highlights beyond our comprehension. So now we need to judge from where we are going to take a meter reading. Overblown highlights looks very distracting, and most of the time its detail is not retrievable in post-processing. At the same time, dark areas can be more tolerated by human eyes, and sometimes the detail in the shadow area is more retrievable. And this is the reason why many new cameras nowadays has got a highlight weighted metering. So when you get a situation like this, use spot metering or highlight weighted metering if your camera has that facility. Give a negative compensation of around one stop or more depending on the contrast between dark and the bright areas. Use a single point focus. Keep your focus point on the brightest area so that the camera thinks that there is more light, and thus it underexposes the picture. So thus your highlights are properly exposed, but the shadow areas become totally dark, and you get such beautiful results. If you have learned something from this video, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing. Also, you can share it with your friends. Thank you and keep exploring.